Have you ever wondered what's the difference between a ground out to the shortstop and a double in the gap? Really, it depends on exit velocity and launch angle. Exit velocity is dictated by three things. One of them is the speed with which the batter swings the bat. The next is the speed with which the ball comes in towards the bat. And then the third is where the ball strikes the bat. Well, what about the launch angle? The launch angle is dictated by two things. One of them is the plane in which the batter swings. And the second thing that dictates the launch angle is where the ball strikes the bat, but this time in a different way. Does it strike the bat on the top and go up like a pop-up? Or does it strike the bat in the center and come off like a line drive? Or does it strike on the bottom and come off like a ground ball? The optimal launch angle really depends on the exit velocity. And this is because when a ball travels through the air, it experiences a drag force and a lift force. The drag force is the same force that you experience when you stick your hand out a moving car window. And for a moving baseball or a moving softball, it's the same. One that has a high exit velocity experiences a significant drag force. And then there's the lift force. A ball that is spinning with backspin flying through the air will have a lift force on it. This lift force means that the optimal launch angle is a little bit lower than what one might expect. The optimal launch angle is something in the range of 25 to 35 degrees, depending on the exit velocity. So now that we know all this, you may ask, well, where does this leave the batter? The best advice really is to focus on the exit velocity and hitting the ball on the sweet spot. The next time you go and watch a game, you'll know a little bit more about the science behind the sport. I'm Kasey Wagoner, and I'm a lecturer in the physics department at Princeton University.